Hello guys, welcome. Let's see the practical working of dynamic traffic management system and its components. We have an IoT module with Wi-Fi enabled in it, and we have connected the LEDs so that it will act as an analog output device. The LEDs have been stuck on so that it can work as an analog output device, with the time slots are very low, medium, high and very high. I have powered on the IoT module with the power bank, and the devices are interconnected with each other. Let me start upon the Xampp server. It will serve the request. Let's see the process flow of the system. Okay, there is central server. In our case, the laptop will act as a central server, and the traffic lights that will interoperate with the central server. The traffic lights can be seen as the camera IO module plus the analog output. So in this case, the arrow shows the process flow of how the system works. Let's see some of the important directories. The first one is the output directory. So this will store the processed image. The second one is the history directory. This will store data in tabular form. Third one is the log directory. For particular files, it will save data. And the test image and the upload, these both will act as a buffer. The upload is where the web module will put the file, and the test is where the object detection module will get the file. Okay, for the web module, we have input, output and log directory. The input is what has the file has been uploaded, and the output and log are the files that the web module has to show. Let me start the IoT directory Python file. This will act as a buffer file, and every 5 seconds it will see and check in the buffer that if there is any file available for requesting, and if so, it will invoke the object detection module file. Let me fire the request with the candidate 1. Okay, the webpack shows me select image to upload. I will choose image 1 and upload it. Okay, it shows me loading and processing image 1, and yes, the object detection module has been invoked by the buffer module. So let me fire another request from candidate 2. I will choose image 2 and upload it. Yes, it shows me loading and processing, and another window has been invoked for the image 2 by the buffer module. All this process will be done prior 5 to 6 seconds before displaying the analog output, because the processing also needs some time to process. And after the process is over, this will automatically close and handle the request to the web module. This have closed, and on candidate 1 and candidate 2, it shows yes, means the request has been handled to the web module. Okay, the both of these web pages shows me the timer. It shows the file that has been uploaded on both of it, and it shows show process image. Let me click upon it. Yes, the output is on the screen. Okay, let me request for analog output on, and this shows low traffic. Analog on success. Let me request analog output off. Log off is success. Here the car 69 and truck 95, all of these states that the system is sure that 96% this is a car, as well as system is sure that 96% it is a truck. Yeah, this project uses Google Stardust object detection libraries, so the system can be made more intelligent by rather than displaying that it is sure that 96% this is a truck, it can say that 96% sure this is an SUV. Let's say what is the processed output on candidate 2. This shows the output image, and the system has performed well with all those confidence values. Let me request your analog output on. It says loading, and yes, it says very high traffic. Let me request analog output off. Analog output off success. It shows image 1 sent for processing success and image 2. This means that both of these images have been pushed out of the buffer. That means test image and upload directory won't be considering these files. Yes. Let's see the output. This will contain the output on the processed files. The file format is like output underscore image name. Let's check the log file. The log file states that first line is like the time to display, the second is the abbreviation, it shows medium traffic, and third and so on, it shows the object that has been detected. Now it shows for the second image. The system has been provided minimum thresholds and maximum threshold values so that depending upon this it can calculate upon what the output to be shown. In this way the output can never fall low than the minimum threshold and can never fall high than the minimum threshold. It works on the amount and the type of object being detected. Let's open the Excel file. This will store the information of all those process images until the system is shut off. Says column 1 is name, column 2 is time, intensity and so on. Okay, also the system is dynamic too. Means let's have an example. I have fired image 3 and it contains car, truck as well as bike and person. So this will add column of person as well as bike and will add values to it. This is the reason why time and intensity has been set prior to the object identified. This system is, or we can say the table is scalable horizontally. Let's check the web module. It contains input, means the files that were uploaded, output and logs. Output and logs are those files that it need to show or display on the web page. This way the system has worked and this is the next process, or we can say the flow graph of how the system works. Thank you.